Hey, I got an opportunity to talk about one of the favorite subjects of mine, which is the gamification of violence. This weekend, there was a fight. It got a lot of attention and not for good reasons. It was by a kid, whether you know these people or not, it's not a big deal. But this kid right up here with the blonde kid is a guy named Jake Paul. He's a huge YouTube influencer. I think he used to be a Disney star. He and his brother Logan are just massive on YouTube. So whether you know that or not, it's pretty relevant. But this kid's a good athlete. He's a good combat athlete, and he's a very good boxer, you know, decent boxer. And he was trying to get some attention, and he had been challenging people. And one of the guys he challenges was this guy right here, Ben Askren. Now, Ben's a well-known UFC fighter, has a pretty decent record. He's a good MMA fighter, and he claims to be a decent boxer. I don't know much about his boxing skills. I know a lot about his grappling skills, where he's great. And this is what's interesting. So Jake, you know, got him. You know, there's a huge age difference. Jake is 24 and Ben's 36. So that's one thing. He's bigger than Ben. And the trash talking was just incredible between these guys. The show itself, there's all sorts of really funny comments. I'll leave that for you guys to check that out. But what I think is really interesting is I haven't heard this angle on it. So I think what I'll do is I'll show you the main clip from the fight that everybody's talking about. And then I want to talk about how it came about and what this is actually going to do for each party. And how does this affect, you know, you're probably trying to figure, well, what does this have to do with self-protection, self-defense? It has everything when you're trying to understand the difference between, you know, a combat sport and real violence. And so we'll talk about that. But let's go ahead and first watch the knockout. Okay, so it's real quick. I'll probably play it 2 or 3 times for you because it's only 8 seconds long. But basically, this is the key part where Jake was able to come in and just land a solid blow and took Ben down. So let's go ahead and play it. Solid. I mean, just, and Ben even said he couldn't believe that, you know, he called himself an idiot for not blocking it. But let's watch it one more time. Boom. Okay. All right, hey, you know, you got to give it to the kid. He can be brash. You cannot like him. You can think he's really arrogant, but he delivered. He did a good job. He ended up winning. He knocked him out, technical knockout. Ben got up, and what you don't see is right after that, he started to go forward, and he was wobbly, and the ref looked at him, and he was just, he could tell that he had been probably mildly concussed on that. What's funny is people were trying to say that, oh, he threw the fight. He did this. He didn't throw the fight. You know, I saw an interview with him just today, and he was just talking about how, hey, you know, I didn't care how it would turn out. I was going to do it because I committed to it. And he just chided himself. He goes, yeah, I let my guard down. I let that punch get in. He goes, I should have known better. He goes, I was in there. He goes, but he caught me. So a couple of things. One, even somebody with tons more experience in the ring, like Ben, can make a mistake. And if the kid, Jake knew how to take care of that. He knew how to take advantage of that. Say, and he came in with a strike. That's where strikes are so interesting. Strikes can, when effectively deployed, they can end it. Again, if you injure the person, you'll get the result. The other thing to look at is Jake was very strategic in how he did this. At least I feel he was. Meaning, he's very smart. He's a great showman. He loves to play the heel. The heel is the bad guy in a situation. You see it a lot in like WWE and wrestling. And you see guys like Conor McGregor brought it to a whole new level. But being the bad guy, like Floyd Mayweather also is another one to think of. Being the bad guy is far more popular and far more profitable oftentimes than being the good guy. Ben was put up as a good guy because he is. Ben's a good guy. And Jake played that up to the hilt. But what was more important was he didn't pick a straight up boxer. You know, his goal was obviously to get publicity. He wanted to fight somebody that was known and ranked. And I thought it was a really smart pick. He got everything he wanted out of it. He got huge, you know, it was covered by multiple celebrities. The promotion was just ridiculous. The commentary was even more ridiculous. But what's interesting is look what you can do with a combat sport. You know, you can get to the point to where you can manipulate things so much that, you know, you can really put things in your favor, you know, that way. Meaning he manipulated the idea. He got the fighter that he wanted. And again, it could have gone the other way, but, you know, he was able to accomplish what he wanted because why? He manipulated the game. He basically said, okay, I want this guy. This guy has this recognition, but he has these skill sets. I've been really working on my boxing skill sets, and I feel really comfortable with my boxing skill sets. And it probably is going to put this guy at a little bit of a disadvantage because, you know, even though he trained for 11 weeks, he's not a classically trained boxer. You know, that's not his first, you know, discipline. His discipline really is wrestling. In fact, he and his brother run multiple wrestling schools. And it was a really well done thing. But oftentimes we try to read into this. Like if you're reading into this, like that Jake's this amazing fighter, we don't know. You know, we need to see him up against some real competition, some real stiff boxing competition. If that's the event that he's going to go, he can't continue to fight guys that aren't true boxers. So we'll see what happens with this and what he wants to do. But it's a great, I see this all the time because I get tons of questions on this, by the way, from all of you. And, you know, what do you think of the fight? What do you think of this? Do you think he threw it? Do you think this? No, I mean, I don't think he threw it at all. But I do think everybody missed the point. They didn't really talk about the idea of how he chose the fighter, what he did, what the goals were, and how he manipulated things to, you know, get the result that he wanted. I thought that was really interesting. Now, that's something you can't do with violence. You know, violence is pretty straightforward, and violence doesn't have any of those parameters. You know, you will not be able to manipulate the situation as far as, you know, set things up exactly the way you want. That's why doing things like set techniques, you know, if all you've learned are set self-defense techniques where they grab you from the right and then you do X, Y, Z, and that's how you train, you're going to really be behind the power curve. You know, you've got to be able to you know, injure in 360 degrees, horizontally, vertically. You got to be really comfortable. You got to be comfortable going up against one person or multiple people. You know, that's just the realities of violence, and that's how you have to train for it. So what's interesting is when you get into combat sports, you know, just even traditional combat sports, you can narrow that down. Why? There are rules. And what's the number one rule in there is you can't really go after direct injury to the human body. You can't deliberately try to maim, cripple, or kill somebody. There's no place for that in combat sports, you know, therefore you can kind of, you know, wiggle around. Now I've got another video that I'm going to show you again with another celebrity. And he manipulated another competition in a really interesting way. And the reason I'm showing you these things is because sometimes we forget how the event was set up and we forget the rules that everybody agreed to. And we forget how the pairing happened. And oftentimes that's really, really important because you don't have any of that in the real world. So anyways, listen, I thought Jake Paul did a great job overall for what he wanted to do. He got the publicity, he got the win, and he did it against a ranked known person. So hey, good for him. It'll be interesting to see if he takes it much further. All right, listen. Make sure you subscribe. Make sure you hit your notification. Make your comments. That's huge. And share this channel with anybody that you think needs real good self-protection information. All the best.